Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Aviation Tech and More. And if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe as I have lots more content coming for you. Also, if you haven't been on the channel in a while, please make sure you check out the two new videos that I posted last week. One of them was an updated channel trailer for 2019, which can show you some of my great improved editing skills, and the other was just a brief channel update slash vlog of what I'm going to be posting on the channel in the future and the direction that this channel is headed in. Also, if you do like the content that you are seeing on this channel, please make sure to share it with your friends, post it on social media, as I do hope to grow my channel in the very near future and gain more subscribers. Anyway, today we are going to be discussing a very popular topic, which is how to control the fan speed on your Mac. You might want to do this for many reasons, one being to help control the thermal throttling that is happening on many new MacBook Pros, or just to keep your Mac as cool as possible when it's on your lap, and other reasons like that. However, do not try what I'm going to show you simply just for the pleasure of turning your fans up and, you know, turning them back down. Only do this if you completely know what you are doing, because you can end up damaging the components if you are not very careful. You can wear your fans out prematurely by running them at maximum speed for a prolonged period of time, or you can even damage the CPU if you accidentally turn the fan speed down too low while you're doing a CPU intensive task. This can cause the CPU to overheat, which will damage it and make it not last as long. So please do not do this unless you know perfectly what you are doing. So in just a minute, I'm going to show you the easiest way to control your Mac's fan speed, at least what I think is the easiest way to control your Mac's fan speed, and that is to download an application called Max Fan Control. It is free for download, and I will have a link in the description below where you can download the application. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright guys, so the first thing that you are going to do is head over to this website called crystallidea.com/maxfancontrol/download. I do have a link in the description to this website to make it easier for you guys to find. As soon as you get to this website, you are going to click on download for macOS, and it will download the installer to your downloads folder. As soon as it is finished downloading, you will launch the installer and follow the prompts to install the software. To control the duration of this video, I do already have the application installed on this computer. So as soon as you do have the application installed, simply go to your launchpad and click on Max Fan Control. If you would like to keep as soon as the application opens, you will be greeted with a window that shows the different fans in your computer, the minimum speed that they can run at, the current speed that they're running at, and the maximum speed that they can run at. In the case of my MacBook Pro, I have two fans that I'm able to control, a fan on the left side and a fan on the right side. But in MacBook Airs, there are only one fan, so don't be concerned if you only see one fan in the list. One of your fans is not broken, you simply have a MacBook that only has one fan. On the right side of the application, you are able to see the current temperature of your CPU by core. And if you do have a MacBook Pro 15 inch, you're able to see the current temperature of your dedicated graphics card, which in my case is the AMD Radeon Pro 560X. If you scroll down, you're also able to see the temperature of your SSD. Not like that's going to matter, because because controlling the fan speed can only help lower the temperature of the CPU and GPU. So if you do notice that the temperature of your SSD is a little high, unfortunately, this is not going to help. You will have to try other methods of controlling that. I will be making a video on that in the near future, so please make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any upcoming videos. So to control the fan speed on your Mac, you have two options. You can either set it to auto, which will allow Max Fan Control, the app, to automatically set your fan speed based on the utilization of the CPU, or you can set it yourself by hitting custom. Then you will see two options. You can set it to a sensor-based, you can set it to a sensor-based value, which is to control your fan speed based on the particular temperature of a component. So let's say I wanted the CPU, let's say I wanted the fan to run at to run faster if the if core one of my CPU runs hotter than 54 degrees Celsius. That is the temperature that the fan speed will start to increase from, and if and then you can set the maximum temperature that you want your CPU to reach before the fans completely run at maximum speed. Now, just to inform you, the when your fans are running at maximum speed, it is extremely noticeable and your Mac will get extremely loud. Also, again, like I did mention in the beginning of this video, don't do this unless you completely know what you are doing, because you can end up damaging the hardware in your MacBook Pro. So that is sensor-based value. You can select a specific component, set a temperature that you set a temperature in which you want the fans to start to increase to try to control the temperature, and then a maximum temperature. When it reaches that maximum temperature, the fans will run at maximum speed until the temperature goes below that max and goes in between the range that you have here. If the temperature is below the starting temperature, the fans will return to idle. The fans will return to an idle state. So that is all about sensor-based value. Now, constant RPM value is really probably what 99% of you are watching this video for, and that is really controlling the fan speed manually. So if you look, if we exit out of this 1 second, over here, you can see, as I did mention before, it says the minimum fan speed that your fan can spin at and the maximum fan speed, and you can control the speed of your fan in between those two parameters. So you can see 2160 is the least. If I click OK, now my CPU fan will only run at or very close to that 2160 value. But as soon as I turn that up to the maximum, which is 5927, and I hit OK, I don't know if you can hear it or not, but my left side fan is absolutely blaring loud, and it is blowing out, it is blowing out air at its maximum speed. You can control the right side fan by just following the exact same procedure. So if I turn that up and click OK, and there we go. It does take a second for the computer to register. It does take a second for the computer to register what you are doing. So if the fan speed doesn't start to increase right away, don't worry, it should within a couple of seconds. I don't even know if you guys can hear me right now, because this computer is extremely loud when both of the fans are running at maximum speed. Now, because I am not doing any CPU intensive tasks right now, I'm going to set them back to auto to prevent damage to any of my components. I don't want to wear the fans out prematurely. And as you can probably hear, the fans have completely shut off. And that is basically about it on how to control the fan speed on your Mac. It is probably a much simpler process than what you might think, and it's very easy and completely free to do so. There are a couple other features that I do want to inform you about related to Mac's fan control. So there is a menu bar icon. So when the program is open, it will show this little fan icon up here, which makes it very easy to show the Mac's fan control window. So if you do close it, you can simply go back up here and hit show Mac's fan control. And there you go right there. It also allows for quick toggling of fan speeds right from the menu bar. It will bring you right up to the fan control window instead of you having to navigate to that. You can see it brings it right up from the menu bar. Also, in preferences, you have the option to start Mac fan control with the system, so that way you don't have to worry about going into Launchpad and turning on the program every time. It can automatically start when you do start up. You can also choose to have a display of temperature, a precise display of temperature when possible. So, you know, as you probably noticed before, it was rounding up to the nearest whole number temperature. So it was saying that my core one on my CPU was 46 degrees Celsius when it might be 45.2. So you can have it show the most accurate temperature that your that the temperature sensor in your CPU can detect by turning on that option. Over here, you have the option to change the color of your menu bar icon. You can see you can make it blue instead of black. Personally, I just leave it black, but that's just me. You can also have it show the fan speed of one of your fans in the menu bar, as you can watch that. Personally, I like to leave that off, and you can even have it show the temperature of one device in the menu bar. So you can see up there in the menu bar now, you can see that core one of my CPU is running at about 60 degrees Celsius, which is quite normal. If you do want to know what a normal temperature is for your Mac CPU, you can go ahead and look that up. But generally, you certainly want to ensure that the temperature does not go above 95 degrees Celsius. You know, anything below that is pretty acceptable. But yeah, I personally like to control the fan speed of my Mac only when I'm doing extreme CPU intensive tasks. So like right before I'm going to render this video out, I will turn on, I will move my fans up to maximum speed to try to prevent thermal throttling. If you do not know what thermal throttling is, I will have a full video on thermal throttling in the very near future. So please make sure to subscribe. So as you can see, based on the video, controlling your Mac's fan speed is not as hard as you probably thought. It's as simple as just downloading an app called Max Fan Control, link in the description, and that's just about it. I will be posting another Mac-related technological tutorial on Thursday, so please make sure to subscribe to the channel for that. Also, make sure to give this video a thumbs up because it keeps me motivated and keeps me going producing more content for you. Like, share, subscribe. This is Matthew for Aviation Tech and More. I will catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.